Police have called it one of the most high-profile missing persons cases in recent history. Melissa Caddick, an accused con woman who defrauded people of more than $20 million. Then, late last year, she vanished. Now, a 7 News Spotlight investigation is lifting the lid on what really happened.
Wife and con woman. Melissa Caddick is one of Australia's most notorious fraudsters, under investigation and raided by ASIC for misappropriating investor funds. She was last seen going for a run in Sydney in November 2020.
Melissa left her personal belongings, which included her mobile phone, wallet and keys.
Then in February, her foot was found by campers 400 kilometres from where she went missing.
DNA from the foot last night matched to DNA sample from Melissa Caddick's toothbrush.
Now a 7 News Spotlight investigation is revealing new details, hearing from her victims.
How much money did you give?
2 million.
Who is Melissa to you?
My sister.
And Melissa's husband, Anthony Coletti, who speaks out for the first time.
Melissa Caddick was my wife. I can't keep silent any longer. It's time for the truth to come out.
Michael Usher investigates in Melissa Caddick, the vanishing.
No one vanishes. I don't think it was an accident at all.
Did you murder your wife?
And for more, we're joined by Michael Usher. Good morning.
Morning, Matt.
The husband, yeah. Anthony, hasn't spoken to anyone before. He was the last person to see her alive. He was also there the entire time. This money was going missing.
He's the one person who was there the entire time and should know everything. So we put all the questions to him. He strikes me as a really interesting fellow, Nat. Believe it or not, he is still desperately in love with Melissa. He misses her extremely. He has lost his wife. Has he quite got his head around what is happening? I don't think so yet. He says that he doesn't know what happened to the money, that he wasn't aware. And there are parts of his story when he tells it to me, certain parts of the timeline in particular, the 24 hours up until her going missing, that I say to him plainly, I don't quite believe your version of events, the conversations in the house after the raid. However, he opens himself up to everything. The questions are not easy at all. The interviews are quite uncomfortable, but he answers them all to the best of his ability. So it's as much as he says and answers, it also leaves you quite intrigued as well.
She took a lot of money from people who were very close to her.
Yep.
Will any of that get back to them?
It's around $25 million. They have seized a fair lot of assets out of the house. She had $2 or $3 million worth of amazing jewellery in the safe downstairs. The house is in question. A lot of artwork has been taken. ASIC, the security investigators, have gone through all of the accounts. They're still doing a bit of that, but it's in the hands of liquidators. Short answer, the investors sadly will get a few crumbs and that's about it.
It's such an intriguing story and so bizarre, isn't it, with the foot on the beach, which obviously you go through.
There are layers of bizarre.
She also leaves behind parents who are the victims of this, a son, a teenage son.
Her parents, her brother, gave her millions. Most of the investors were close to her. She knew them. How she did this is quite extraordinary, and trying to understand Melissa Caddick's personality is extremely confusing. But her son, I really do believe that's one of the more tragic aspects of the entire story. He's 15 years old. The relatively good news is he's still at school, he's got good mates, he lives with Anthony and Anthony's caring for him, and he's in a bit of a bubble. He doesn't quite understand what mum has done, but as we all know, in the years to come, when he Googles his mother's name for the rest of his life, it's going to be Melissa Caddick, one of Australia's greatest con artists. And that's deeply sad for him.
And we still don't know what happened.
It's an absolute mystery about exactly how she died.
Yep. Thank you, Michael. And you can see the full 7 News Spotlight investigation on Sunday night at 7 p.m.